we're beautiful.
Hello everybody and welcome back to Oracle Angels to 122. I'm going to be doing your twin, your daily reading, okay? We're doing your daily reading, okay? So let's start off with Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. What do we have, please, Angel Guides, for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus, please? This is for the week commencing, 7th? Yeah, I think it's the 7th. But that is just a general guide. It is just a reference. So it does not mean that it's going to resonate, okay, from the 7th. So please bear that in mind. Also, in general, this may or may not resonate. So please take it how you will. So this is from the 7th of April. Oh, wrong way. Give it another quick shuffle. Perfect. Okay, Aries, what do we have for Aries? Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus, please, Angel Guides. What do we have for Aries? Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. What do we have for Aries? Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus, please. Let's cut the deck. Bad cut there. It happens. Okay. Right. So, your initial energy is the Six of Swords. Crossing that over is the Ace of Cups. What is carrying you through is the Princess of Coins. What's on your mind? The Temperance. What is in your past or your recent past is the Death. Moving forward, you have the Nine of Cups, okay? How you perceive yourself or how people perceive you. How you perceive your environment or how people see you within your own environment. Your hopes, your fears is the Knight of Swords. And Two of Coins is your overall outcome. Your overall energy is the Strength. So you could be possibly connecting with a Leo. This could also be your strength here as well. Please remember that when you look at your birth chart, okay, your moon, where it was placed as well, has a huge influence on what cards will show up in your reading, okay, and what energy you take up. My moon is in Leo. So as you can see, if I get a Leo card, that's kind of my own energy, especially if I'm not dealing with anybody who is a Leo. But that does not mean that I will not be dealing with a Leo maybe in the future. Okay, so please remember this as well, your ascendant and also your sun sign. So your strength, overall energy, courage, confidence, persistence, dealing with situations with immense strength, okay, and having the courage as well. Also, this could indicate a lot of compassion and having the patience as well to control your temper, especially, or even your impulses in regards to a situation that might be just, you know, really getting on your nerves right now. Okay, so before we start, let's get some oracle cards out for you guys. Let's see what messages we have. See what messages we have for you. What messages do we have for Leo, Sun, Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus, please? So we have, these are all the wrong way today. Oh, new moon in Leo. Oh well, what do you know, you could be dealing with the Leo. Confidence is your key to success. Okay, let's get one more. What else do we have for Aries? I was about to say Leo again, really. We have your commitment is being tested. Okay, let me move that away. So your commitment is being tested. Right, interesting. We are going to go ahead and use some clarifiers as well. to see what we need to know. Okay, so looking at your current energy we have here, okay. Now for some of you could be transitioning, relocating as well. You could be moving from one place to another. I also see this as somebody going into a karma situation in regards to perhaps relationships, partnerships of some sort. I feel a very calm environment here, whereas before I feel like there was not a calm environment here. So clearly this is showing that there has been a calm after a storm that's happened here as well. I also do feel that this is about taking responsibility now, to do what is necessary and to do what is right in order to move into a calm, caring, nurturing, environment. So I feel for some of you really are moving into a calmer situation here, whether that is relocating or whether that is just a relationship issue here on a personal level. There is definitely this calm coming because what's crossing the situation is the Ace of Cups. So somebody here may be feeling a little bit blocked by emotions, okay, or having to suppress their emotions while necessarily moving on with their lives, okay, in a calm manner. But this is also telling me as well that there is a lot of love there, a lot of love, a lot of compassion, okay. There is a want, there is a need, okay, to become more calmer in a relationship, in a partnership, whoever this is. Right. What's carrying you through is the Princess of Coins. So for some of you, you could be really looking deep down within your own feelings, okay, in regards to, is this what you want? I feel that there's still a bit of maturing to do, though. This could be you, Aries. This could be your person, but I feel like there is some sort of maturing to do still, okay? Because I mean, you still are a page at the moment. That's what it's showing. It could be your person as well that, is showing up as a page at the moment. And there could be an age difference here as well. Could be an age or just general personality where somebody just comes across quite immature. I would also say that this could be a message as well that you're waiting for, or some money that you are waiting for to come through at the moment. I'm waiting for some news, okay, to come, but it hasn't come yet. I also feel that this is an opportunity as well that you're trying to take or that you're thinking about taking here. Okay, could be dealing with an earth energy here. We've got Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. We've also got the Death here, which is Scorpio. We've got some air energy here. I think we've got a bit of everything going on here, really. What's on top of your mind is the Temperance. Yeah, again, see, needing to get some balance in a situation. This is kind of guided. It's guided. You're being guided to finally get some balance in your life, get some order in your life. But I also feel that this is about needing to come to some sort of compromise, and perhaps you're thinking about coming to some sort of compromise in regards to the situation. Temperance, it's also about having belief in the situation, in yourself, that you have you can actually meet this person halfway or meet the situation halfway. But I do feel that this is about balance again. There's a lot of cards showing here about balance, things, going into a calmer situation here. In your recent past, we had the Death card here. So something could have ended that was chaotic. You then went into a transition and came out of it. With your head up high, of course. And I do feel here as well that that whatever you had gone through has made you stronger. You know that saying, what doesn't break you makes you stronger, right? I feel that's what's happened here. Moving into your near future, do I need to say any more? This is your wishes and your hopes. This is you being very comfortable. This is you very satisfied. This is you very happy and your wishes being fulfilled. I also feel here that you have a lot of choices here as well in regards to decisions, or this could also be you overindulging. Okay, so remember that's your near future, so that's not now. It could be for some. Okay. Moving on, and how you feel within yourself, though, you feel quite stressed, you feel quite burdened. So, this could be mentally, feeling quite stressed mentally. I think that with everybody trapped inside of their houses right now and there's a lockdown going on, there can be a lot of stress right now, you know, with not just a lot of people are going to be going through stress right now. But I think that this is going to come towards an end for those who are still working. I feel that this is immense amount of stress, okay, and responsibility that you are taking. But I feel that to some extent, you know that whatever it is that you are working on or have been doing, whether that is helping other people, whether that is working from home and dealing with family life, or whether that's just because you're stuck in the house. And of course, it can take a mental strain on everyone. So I do feel, though, that you know that at the end, you've achieved what it is that you needed to achieve, okay, once this is over, okay? How people perceive you, how people see you as somebody who's heroic. Okay, so you could be working actually for as a public figure. You could be working as somebody who is an entrepreneur, a healer. You could be working as somebody who is in the public eye, who has gained recognition for the work they've done, and they see you as somebody who has progressed so well, who has moved forward with victory, who has a self-confidence to believe in themselves and others, to do what they can, okay, for others. So that is great energy there. Very great energy. With the Knight of Swords, this is your either your hopes or your fears, okay? So you could be hoping to kind of move forward and share your opinions with people, but I feel that also that you may come across a little bit cold towards some people, a little bit aggressive in the way you talk, but that is not really what you mean to do. Okay, so clearly, so that is not what you mean to do. But this is also talking about communication, and this is like clear communication that you want. Now, somebody else could be coming towards you and throwing their opinions at you, and this is probably something that you could deal with in regards to fear. We're going to clarify this card because we can get two answers out of this, and we need to know obviously what or who this is. In your outcome, if I can grab the card, in your outcome, you have the Two of Coins. So things are still looking a little bit imbalanced, right? Okay, things are still looking like they're just up and down. And I feel that you are still looking at trying to get some balance in the situation, right? But I feel that if you adapt, okay, to changes, okay, and have good management in regards to whether you're doing too many things at once, there will be a very good balance eventually in regards to this situation. Okay, so let's go in with some clarifiers. I want to find out what the Six of Coins is. Angel guys, please clarify the Six of Swords, please. Not taking that one too soon. Please clarify the Six of Coins, please. Six of Swords. Six of Swords, please. Please clarify the Six of Swords, please, Angel Guides. See that Strength card right there again. So, needing the strength to deal with all of the stuff that you are dealing with currently. Why is the Six of Swords here, please, Angel Guides? Why is the Six of Swords here, please? High Priestess. Gold. Two major arcanas there. And you've got the Eight of Cups. Yeah, somebody's definitely moving into a more calmer situation. But I feel that as they're moving away from this karma situation, they're not ready to talk about it. They don't even want to explain to anybody about the situation. They're just gonna stay very quiet until it's the right time to, when they feel it's the right time, then they will say what they need to say. But at the moment, with the High Priestess, and the world here, I think somebody here is staying quiet. I feel like somebody here is moving into a calmer situation, but I feel that there are also going to be some struggles, okay? And I think that these struggles are within you, Aries, or whether this is with the person that you're dealing with. But I feel that the struggles are going to be there. But with the Eight of Cups being here, okay, so it's also telling me that somebody is just basically withdrawing themselves. Now, in regards to work, somebody here may be traveling a lot, okay, so this could indicate that there's a lot of travel going on where a person cannot be in one place due to their work commitments. At the moment, traveling might be a restriction, so when we look at travel, we could be talking about going from one city to another, in regards to work, okay? Depending on where you live around the world. Eight of Cups to me is telling me here that there are some struggles. There are, but this is just about finding that peace, that balance, that tranquility for yourself. High Priestess is definitely there telling me that, you're trying to keep things to yourself, okay? You're trying to keep them on the low. You're using your intuition, okay, about this, but this is also about how you see the situation in your own mind, okay? But this is like clear seeing. So basically, you could call it clairvoyance, okay? But I think clear seeing is like a direction of knowing where you want to go and where you need to be. And I think that that's the completion there, okay? Especially with the World card, you're definitely moving on an emotional level too, I feel. So if it's not a travel, it's definitely emotional. I also feel this could, for a collective amount of Aries, this has got to do with a twin flame connection. And the reason why I say that is because you've got Eight Cups here, two is missing, Two of Cups is twin flame connection or a partnership. So, somebody here is walking away from that. Let's clarify the Princess of Coins. Why is the Princess of Coins here, please, Angel Guides? Why is the Princess of Coins here, please? Why is the Princess of Coins here, please? So you got the Four of Cups, you got the Three of Pentacles. So somebody was waiting for a response or some news in regards to something that they have been really thinking about or they were really focused about. They were contemplating about the situation. They weren't really happy about it, as somebody was expecting somebody to give them that news, okay? It could have been in regards to business, work. This could also have been in regards to a person that you were dealing with. Got a lot of fours here. Yeah, I think that either you or this person was definitely holding back from putting in any effort at all in this situation. Four is also telling me as well that this person or you, Aries, had a lot of limitations here as to how much you are going to do, how much effort you're going to put in the situation. I felt that you could not rely on this person, Aries, or this person could not rely on you in regards to putting in the effort, the work that was needed. So let's see why the Temperance is here. Why is the Temperance here, please, angel guides? Why is the Temperance here? Why is the Temperance here, please? Okay, so the Temperance, okay, we have the Magician. So somebody, yeah, is definitely working on gaining some balance in a situation. Four of Swords, they just want to, you know, relax and just get rid of all the stress and the tension, really. With the Seven of Cups, I think they're looking at their choices. So while they've kind of gone into this mode of relaxation and, you know, thinking about things while they're just, you know, lying there and chilling out and things like this, okay, I think that they're looking at their options and what's best to put the effort and their skills into. And this is even about manifesting certain choices that they have. I do feel like somebody here is about to just move off quietly, and I think that that is where these choices are coming from, because we have the Seven of Swords right at the bottom here. So it's kind of like taking your things and just going, you know, into a calmer situation, just moving off quietly. I think there's a lot of analysis going on here. There's a lot of thinking going on here of what is the best maneuver here, okay? Somebody's really focusing, though, however, on these choices that they have while they've just kind of, like, gone into their I wouldn't even call it a hermit mode. I would call it in a more relaxed kind of, when you're lying there in your bedroom and just chilling and you're trying to think about the things, you know. I think that that's what this is about. Let's clarify where the Death is here. Sorry guys if my voice is a little bit muffled. I am testing out a new mic, so hopefully it will be okay. Got the Ace of Pentacles, got the Five of Wands and the Nine of Cups. So somebody went through a big change here, a very big change. They manifested this change. I feel that there could have been a conflict between you and this person as well. I really do feel that there could have been a conflict between you and this person as well. But with the Nine of Cups again being there, I think that, you know, you were satisfied with the outcome when you came out of this transformation, you know, this this transition. You were feeling quite happy. I think that there was some challenges there. But with the Nine here, there was a completion. There was a completion, or close to completion, really. Let's go to your Nine of Cups, see why the Nine of Cups is here. I don't think I need to, but I'm just going to pull out maybe one or two cards for this one. Why is the Nine of Cups here, please? Why is the Nine of Cups here, please? Why is the Nine of Cups here, please? So the Nine of Cups, hopes, wishes, dreams coming true, an end of a tough cycle. This is an end of a tough cycle. You know, you've got the Star and the Ten of Wands there. So this is end of a tough cycle. This is you having the achievement, being recognized for what you've been doing and finally being able to put that crap down or whatever it was that you were doing that was causing so much stress. And you've just managed to kind of sit back and relax. And that is beautiful energy there in the near future. Let's clarify why the Ten of Wands is here. I think that there was a lot of decisions that you've had to make in regards to work and relationships. Stress is obviously taking a big toll here on a situation. I am seeing work here mostly, if in regards to anything at all. And I think that's what's causing the burden here, the stress. Now we see a relationship here. So yeah, some kind of partnership, whether this is in work or whether this is in a relationship, definitely. This is actually showing here that there is a lot of stress. You've kind of gone into the hermit mode. Oh my God. I was about to say hermit when I said the Four of Swords. Wow, that's crazy. You and your partner could have gone into a hermit mode as well, but I think that this is your card here. So this is actually showing to me that you've kind of withdrawn yourself, okay? You are being guided, or you are guided, to move forward, okay? To take your feelings, your heart, your feelings, this offer somewhere else to perhaps somebody who deserves it, because somebody here was definitely not putting in the effort, you know. And if somebody's not putting in the effort, then why are you, why, you know? I mean, I feel relationships are two-sided, you know, and it takes two to work on a relationship. And clearly this person hasn't been. You can waste all your life just trying and trying with a person, but if they haven't already, and they love you, then they're not going to, and that's from experience. So let's clarify the Six of Wands here. Why is the Six of Wands here, please? Why is the Six of Wands here? I got the Three of Swords, yeah, and the Empress and the Five of Pentacles. So somebody here is definitely getting recognized for their achievements, but I feel that with the Three of Swords here, somebody here is definitely feeling heartbroken. I think this is within themselves. So outside, you know, everybody's saying, wow, you know, you've achieved this, you've done it, you finally did it, you know. But within you, you're very much heartbroken. You're very much heartbroken, but you're coming out of that, you know. Because you know that you are the Empress or the Emperor, gender's not specific. But you know who you are, you know what you want, you know what you stand for, right? And you know you deserve better. And I feel here with the Five of Pentacles that you're coming back in from the cold. You are. But still, a lot of challenges. There is a lot of challenges here. Eight of Wands, yeah, you're definitely making swift movement, swift action here to, you know, come back in from the cold. Whether this is communicating with this person as well, because we do have the Knight of Swords here, which is hopes or fears. So, you know, we have the communication card here as well. So, you know, this could also mean taking charge finally, being the Empress, coming back in from the cold and taking charge of the situation and, you know, showing your authority in the situation, which is the Knight of Swords here, and just telling this person clearly, you know, what it is and how it is. Clarify the Knight of Swords, please, angel guides. If this is in regards to work, I feel that somebody here definitely did not carry through. Somebody here has kind of didn't live up to their expectations, right? Somebody could have even been trying to tarnish somebody's fame, somebody's victory, somebody's efforts as well here. But this is only for a collective amount, because I could read this in so many ways right now. The input that's coming in from this is crazy. So let's see why the Knight of Swords is here. I did not have any reversals, but now the Knight of Swords is a reversal. So somebody's coming in here, okay, with an opinion to share, okay? Somebody's coming here with a lot of action here, and swiftly communicating what it is that they need to say. And I feel here that in regards to coming forward and trying to make successful moves here, somebody else, on the other hand, is causing some sort of resilience and is being very guarded. They could also be watching you coming in, because we have the Knight of Swords here in reverse, and the Knight of Swords here in reverse is somebody who is ready to start a fight. They're ready. So if you're coming in with your opinions, don't think that they're going to hold back. And this could be you as well, Aries. So just flip the energies if it resonates. But somebody here is kind of like, you want a fight? I'll give you a fight. Okay. When really the intention was to never have a fight in the first place. And I think that this person can cause a lot of destruction. Their thoughts are not grounded. They're all over the place. And I don't like that energy. But I feel like this person is trying to win, whichever way they want to, or they're trying to win. They're really trying to win. Let's see why the two of the Ace of Cups came out. Somebody's trying to win. Let's see what the Two of Cups is here as your overall outcome. Why is the Two of Cups here, please, Angel Guides? Why is the Two of Cups here? Why is the Two of Cups here, please, Angel Guides? Yeah, there's a need to get some balance in the situation, do what is right, and that is giving and receiving in return with the Two of Pentacles again. Yeah, a lot of balance here, a lot of balance. I'm seeing the need to have balance, the need for truth, the need to communicate in order to get some balance here in the situation. A lot of balance. I'm seeing three scales here. You see this? Okay, let me show you. This here, you've got the Judgment. Now, if you realize that in the original Rider-Waite deck, this would have had some scales here, okay, with the Justice card. And then you have the Six of Pentacles, which also has a scale. And then Two of Pentacles is balance. So there's a lot of balance needed here in your overall outcome. And I feel that there you're going to do the right thing and get some balance in the situation. You just need to have the strength, the courage, the persistence to do this, because you know what? You're there. You're there. You have this. You've got this. Okay, look at this. There's completion. The Strength and the World card. What more do you need? This is perfect. Clearly, your commitment is being tested here, as you can see that with everything that is going on. So just hang on in there, okay? Just have the persistence here. I feel that there's a high level of confidence here, especially with the Strength card being here as well, with the Six of Wands being here. You've got the Eight of Wands being here, and you have also here the confidence is key to success. So I really do feel, yeah, that, you know, you have the confidence to just do what you need to do, okay? And you will get through this. It's just all about having the balance right now, okay? And doing what you need to do to get that balance, to do what is right, and cut out a person from this who you feel is serving you no good, who's causing you stress, because I can see that things are going very, very well for you, very well indeed. Okay, Aries, thank you so much for joining me. I hope that this resonated. If it did, it simply wasn't your message. For all those viewers who are watching me, please do leave a like, share and subscribe. Without you guys, without my subscribers, this channel would not be. Right now, we all need each other and your support is immensely appreciated. I'm going to try getting some more videos out there as well to help you guys relax your minds a little bit more, especially with the three-part meditation series. I'm definitely going to get around to it now soon. So hang on in there. Again, don't forget to subscribe down below. You know where that button is. Also, don't forget to hit me a like too. All right, take care, guys. Bye.